described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Films Media Group presents The Legend, the Bessie Coleman story. Someone lights a match and uses the flame to light a lantern. A black woman sits in front of it.
Right there on the shelf next to you.
She takes down the open Bible from the shelf.
Her name is Elizabeth, and she's my 10th born.
A younger black woman.
At the turn of the century, it was not unusual for African Americans born in the South not to have birth certificates. Hospitals, like most civilized establishments, were off limits to them. So, births were done at home with the help of a midwife. It was not uncommon for birthdays to be recorded down in a family journal or a Bible.
A recording is shown beside her.
Susan Coleman said her 10th child was born January 26, 1892, in Atlanta, Texas. She would later tell people she gave birth to 13 children, raised 9 of them, and add with a loving smile, and one of them was flat crazy. She was talking about her 10th born, Elizabeth Bessie Coleman.
The described and captioned media program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.